Right, this next task, you're going to be creating a data dictionary and creating a database and just running through a practice task very similar to the internal without the documentation. A bit more straightforward, so you're going to need to think about what's actually going on here, but this is just to introduce you to the skills and also revise some of the skills that you'll need for the internal. So I've got UAMP running here, and what you're going to want to do is open up PHP MyAdmin and the www folder. So in the www folder, you are going to create a new folder and call it internal practice. Now it's best when you are naming folders for web servers to use all lowercase and no spaces. If you want, you can use underscores, but spaces will put in a symbol that you've probably seen sometimes, like a percentage 20 at the top, and it's not what you want. So you can use an underscore, but internal practice. Ignore the fact that I've used capitals on these other ones. So we've got internal practice, and it's an empty folder at the moment. We'll put some stuff in there later. And on the PHP MyAdmin site, you're going to load that up because you'll need it shortly. So I've created a data dictionary for this, and you can see if I zoom in that in this database, which I've planned out and I've thought about it. And of course, you're going to get specifications that will say what your database needs to do. So we've got here name, varchar 25, the user's name. So that's the name of the field, that's the type it's going to be, that's how long it's going to be, and that's just a brief description of what it does. Now you can see as I've got down into the bottom here, I have used four different descriptions, and I just want to explain those a little bit when I get down there. House type varchar, length 3, and this one is a good description. The house group that the user is in, it's comprised of a house letter followed by a teacher code, e.g. SSH. And then I've got the group, varchar length 10, age group the student is in. For example, under 14, under 16. So what you want to do with the description is usually provide some kind of example input or example that could be in that field in the database. If it's a bool type though, or Boolean, and if you remember from class we talked about Boolean, it can only have yes or no in it. So this is called 100 meter, and that's for the 100 meter event. It's a bool type. It can only have length of 0 or 1. Now, you could use int with length 1. The difference is that int length 1 will still allow 10 values, 0 through to 9. Bool will only allow 2 values, so it's a bit more accurate. You can't accidentally put in a value of 2 or 3 or 4. It only allows 0 and 1. So then there's some of that data validity in there, making sure that the correct data is being entered into the database. And we've got here true if the user is enrolled in that event. But that's not a very good description because it doesn't really describe what the field is all about. This one's a better one. 200 meter Boolean length 1, 200 meter sprint, true if the user is enrolled, 0 if not. Okay, and the following two, this part's pretty straightforward, but they're not very good descriptions. So anyway, I've got my data dictionary here and I'm just going to move that over to the right and I'll bring it back in shortly. And in here, I'm going to create a new database and I'm going to give it the name DB underscore internal practice. Now, it is a good idea when you're naming variables to use what's called camel case, which is generally the first letter of a word in a string is lowercase, and then any additional words after that are uppercase. So this is going to be called internal practice. I'm going to create that. I'm going to go into this and I'm going to create a table. So a decent table name here would be something like sports entries. And number of columns, let's go back and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns. Click go. So I can create this. So if I remember what it was name, it was varchar. I'll just go through and put the field names in first. House, group, 100M, 200M, discus, and 3000M. And the reason I put 3000M at the end is if you remember on the actual sheets that you filled out, there were several open events. The hurdles were an open event, I think, and the 3000 meter was an open event. So I put that at the end. Okay, so I've got those names in there. This is going to be Varcha. And I said that's 23, that was 3, group was like 10. So the group is like under 14, under 16, and so on. So there's not going to be any more than 10 characters there. 100 meters is going to be a Boolean. And these are all going to be Booleans. And so they don't actually need a length in here. Now the primary key. And in class, someone had the good suggestion to make the name and the house a primary key. You could even go and group as well as another primary key, and that would allow you to have two people in the same house group with the same name but different ages, and that would be very unlikely, but I would recommend just keeping it as name and house. Of course, when you do your real database, you're going to need more than just first name. You should break it up into first name, surname, maybe initials even. And house group can just be house group. Group or age group, you might decide to call it age group instead if it helps you to understand it a little bit better. And so I've made my table. I'm going to click save. So from here, what we've got now is a table in the database. If I look at the structure, I can see it's got name, house, group, 100 meters, 200 meters, discus, 3000 meters. And that's it. I've made my table. I don't need to do anything more from there. What I want to do now is in the next video, it's going to be to create a form, a web form that's going to be able to input data into this.